Welcome to the 12th EGEE screencast on grid computing brought to you by the Direct User Support Team. During this screencast, we will discuss the gLite API. The gLite API provides the freedom for the developers and the users to customize and develop new tools in order for them to fulfill their needs. gLite provides a wide variety of tools and services for building a production grid infrastructure, and for the most of the services, an API is available. The gLite APIs are available for many programming languages such as C and C++, Python and Java. Some of the available APIs are shown in this table. WMProxy is a simple service providing access to the workload management system. LFC is used to locate files that are stored in storage elements, while gFile, which was presented in a previous screencast, is used to perform input and output operations on grid files directly. VOMS API is used to interact with the virtual organization membership services, and MyProxy is used for managing X509 PKI security credentials. Logging and bookkeeping service tracks jobs managed by the WMS. The AMGA, was also presented in the previous screencast, allows users to store various metadata related to their stored data files. RGMA API is an implementation of the grid monitoring architecture, and LCG Util are high-level gLite data management APIs. Of course, if you wish to use any package, it must be installed in the user interface. If not, you can contact your system administrator and kindly ask him or her to install them. The documentation spans from decent to well-documented, and it is available at the gLite website along with many interesting links. One of the advantages of APIs is the ability to combine different APIs and produce useful results. For the purposes of this screencast, we have developed two tools and combined them into a single service. First, we must describe our needs. It would be very convenient for us to be able to check the statuses of job ID files without logging into the user interface every time. A Twitter account which could update upon status change would be ideal. Also, a gTalk account, which is the instant messenger coupled to your Gmail, could serve as a bot. This project, as difficult as it may seem, due to the availability of the APIs, can be implemented quickly. The implementation was done in Python, which has available all the necessary libraries. XMPPy was utilized to contact gTalk, while Python Twitter was used for Twitter. WMS UI API stands between Python and the workload management system. It will provide the job status when given a job ID. Getting a little deeper within the source code, the functions of our program will be distributed to four Python files. gwittertalk.py is the main service, gtweet.py containing the gtalk and Twitter wrappers, and botcommands.py will define the behavior of the program based on the gtalk input. The last file is jobupdates.py, a job ID-oriented wrapper of the WMS UI API. The script reads the contents of a job ID file and updates Twitter upon any change. The time step for the update is 5 seconds and the fields we chose to send are shown here. They are the job ID, the status and the status reason. Let us now try this program in practice. We shall submit two jobs and monitor their statuses over Twitter and gTalk. The job ID file is the argument of the main program, the gwittertalk.py. Now, by following the desired user in Twitter, we can have a real-time image of our job processes. Chatting with a bot over gTalk is also an option. We can type check and wait for the output, or type a job ID, any job ID, and we have the current status on our screens. If we update the file with one more job, its status will get updated also. The program will stop if we type stop or kill. As you can see, all the traffic is printed in the standard output and can be redirected to a single log file. This concludes our screencast of the gLite API. We hope we've inspired you in using the gLite API to develop your own tools and fulfill your needs. On behalf of the Direct User Support Team, thank you for watching.